Okay, we just discussed yesterday about the syllabus agenda as well as we just covered some demons, how it is working and all. So tell me any questions. This is a continuing session. So if you have any questions or yesterday, whatever we have discussed, just let me know. We can discuss that point and directly we can go forward.
Can you just do a brief up about yesterday's session? Just 5 minutes.
Just a walkthrough, if possible.
Okay. That's also fine.
Just a walkthrough, if possible. Whatever the meeting is recorded has been posted in YouTube or?
Yeah. It's already, we have shared that links also. Okay, yesterday how Hadoop is working, that architecture only we have discussed. What are the daemons is available? What is the responsibility for the particular daemons? So insight to the Hadoop, what are the layers is available, difference between the Hadoop processing layer and storage layer, as well as difference between MapReduce and Spark Engine. That is yesterday we have discussed. And then we just go forward with what are the Hadoop daemons is available. Inside how the Hadoop's functionality is working. Each daemons, what is the responsibility? Such things we have discussed. Via this architecture, we can do. So this video is already posted in our channel. You can refer from that. Channel name is Big Datapedia. So how this is working inside, how the block will be stored and how it will be pick the data while processing that, everything, the low level we just discussed yesterday. How the job is created with respect to the job, how node manager is working, and insight to the node manager, how container and application master is running on it. This is only we have discussed. Okay. Our channel name is Big Datapedia. You just go and check this yesterday video. Okay, it's posted recently. We just posted this one. Okay, any questions? Few of them I can see yesterday overall join, there only is available. So any questions on yesterday's, or can we start to go forward?
Okay. Latest question is Hadoop. What is the latest question of Hadoop?
Why is this breaking? Come again.
Sorry, can you hear me now?
Yeah, now it's fine.
My question is, what is the latest question of Hadoop and Spark VR?
Suddenly, your voice is being reduced. I'm so sorry, I cannot understand your question.
Okay, I'm just thinking in chat, okay?
Okay, no problem, fine. So during that, we just recall it, what is doing, named, what is the functionality of Nameless doing? It is following the metadata. Metadata on Hadoop cluster. Just a two lines of information, I just pause it. And intimate to yarn for the processing layer operations and data node, which is have only actual data with respect to block sizes. So default block size is 128 MB in 2x and 3x. Yeah, this is Hadoop 3x version we are going to discuss. Right now, we are going to compare it only, Mitchell. What are the difference between Hadoop 1x and 2x and 3x? Everything we will be planning to discuss. Right now, we will be going with the daemons. After that, I just giving some deviations between Hadoop 2x and 3x as well. Yeah, in a practice, we are going to use only Hadoop 3x versions.
Okay, thanks.
3.2.0. Okay. After end of the session, I will show you a small demo projects for your curiosity, how our sessions look like. At the end, I can show you. Next, secondary name node. Keep on monitor on the primary name node. On standby name node. focus for the high availability. And more than one standard input on SDFF, three expressions you can use it. Yet another resource negotiator. This is only negotiate the resources. Process and the estimation timeline for each processing jobs. And resource manager create the jobs with respect to the client request from Yarn and allocate the process with node managers. Node manager is going to be process the particular job with multiple divided task. So container, each node manager have to create a container to reserve the memory. Memory to process the task. Application master is nothing but it is reserve the processor for threading to continue this each job success, each tasks. And then block size, by default in Hadoop 1x is a 64 MB, 2x should be a 128 MB, as well Hadoop 2x and 3x. Okay, so based on the architecture, this is only we have discussed how the data will be stored inside, how the data will be processed via this our Yarn application, and how the jobs will be created, each one job how will be responded and inspected execution concept. This is we have discussed with high level overview with the operation flow. That's it as today. So today we just continue with the stuff that, so block size we just reach it. Processing is started and the data node process we can discuss. Okay, then we can discuss about input split. So difference between input split and block size. Anybody have some idea? What is the difference between block size and input split? This is a very important question in interviews. Mostly they will ask.
It would split the data.
How? Okay, fine.
Like each line by line, it will go through and it will split the data.
Not exactly. Okay, we can take this is only one data node. Okay, because we have more clusters, so I just take only one data node for our understanding. Here inside only the data, we are going to store it as a multiple box. So this is the block one. We are supposed to use it. So this is the block two, enter space. This is the block three, something is like a block four. Four blocks data we have stored here, we are going to process it. So each one of them, I said already, the block size should be a 128 MB. Okay, so if suppose I have a data, 512 MB of data, I want to store it. Okay, first scenario, file should be abc.txt without compressions. I'm going to use it. This data, if suppose I'm trying to write into our environment, Hadoop environment, this will be split into four blocks and will be stored in these four blocks. Okay, no issues. With respect to this one, we have to calculate this input state, because based on the input state only, our processing layer is going to create a mappers. That's the concept. Number of input state equal to number of mappers. Because if suppose I want to run a job, this 512 MB of data, I want to process it, then how many mappers will be generated by default? Something they will ask the question. If it is a non-compressed file, so 512 MB divided by 128, then it should be a four block will be allocated. So this four block you are going to split and store into same node as well as replicate. Because the first data will be stored in one place, after that only replicate started. Okay, this four blocks will be allocated here. All the data is available. So suppose I'm going to start my process, it will be going to create four input split here. Whenever I'm going to call the MapReduce jobs, it is not moving. I'm going to process by a MapReduce job. This is going to be created. MapReduce, a spot, whatever. It is referred based on that input split only. So it is going to be calculated and create four input split. And then four mapper will be reduced, created. And then the process has to be started. There is a pipeline design, it's available. Let's suppose, so four mapper we have to process for the at least 512 MB of data, whatever it is. And the replication after that only, once the data will be stored, then only the replication has to be moved to some places. Another one scenario is the same data, I'm going to load into Hadoop environment, but this time I'm going to use as a compressed. With gzip compression, I'm going to use it. Here, it should create only one blocks. Okay, just feel the difference, because if it is a compressed file, in a compress also few of the compression, they will allow you to create multiple input split, but few of the compressions, we cannot split it. So such kind of inputs, such kind of files, we are going to store it. It is going to make some high level compression and create only one input split. No, not a four. Okay, by mistake I just mentioned. This is a four block only, actual, because block size is four. Gzip compression. Now this data will be look like it's going to be stored here, but input split is going to be create only one here. Reason behind. That is a concept is called a checksum is available. Based on the checksum, it's going to be read the data and process it. Here, one input script only will be created. So MapReduce job is going to be created based on the input script only. So it will be create only one map. Okay, this is mostly will confuse, and a few of them will be theoretically they you will be studied block sizes of physical storage and input splitters are kind of logical storage, but actual depends on your data. That input split will vary. So if it is a pocket file and a compressed format, you're supposed to use it, then input split will be reduced to compare with your normal files without compression, because you can split the data there. Any questions in this? Just check about checksum if you want to know more details about this. Okay. But mostly they will ask about the block size and input split in interviews. These are very important questions. Yeah, Chal, any question? We are getting creachings from you.
Actually, my question is like, still the companies are using MapReduce for batch processing?
Even for a, I just mute you, just a minute. Sorry, Mitchell, I will answer your question, but your voice is, we are getting very, some creachings on the back end. I'm just muting you. Okay, I will answer your question definitely. MapReduce jobs is most of the places nobody is using, but the concept wise, you must know the MapReduce if you want to clear the interviews, some places. And even a Spark also, data distributions, it will be followed by your MapReduce concept only. Like number of mapper is equal to that number of tasks will be created, number of partitions. So based on the partitions only in Spark, you're going to do all the analysis. So you must correlate with MapReduce before understanding about the Spark. That's very important. At least the theoretical part, how it is working under. Because based on that, they will be infer the MapReduce program and they will be creating via in-memory analytics. So you must know all the concept, whatever you'll be practicing, that will be available in Spark also. Spectre executions and the dynamic allocation, something they will be modified. As well as if you are going to do some MapReduce and combiner operation, there also they will be creating a lot of the RDD transformations, like reduce by key, combine by key, like that they will be developed. So Spark is will be taking the inference from the MapReduce only. So you know the concept. That's very okay. Sir, whether Java knowledge is required for big data. As of my experience, some places, if you're a fresher, they will tutoring you and will make some Java related project. But if you're experienced, so you'll be going to work more with the data, very good with SQL programming concept, Java is not mandatory. My experience, I'm saying, because I'm working in multiple companies, that they first they will be expect for Java programming development. But few of the places not required, because you're going to work with Hive as well as Spark and other tools. There you can, you have an alternative. So with respect to that, they have some different project allocations available. So it's not mandatory. But if you know Java and you have good with Java, you have more operation, more integrations with big data and other Java combination, you can do that. That is sure. Only for data related. If you want to enter into data science, Java will not help you. Those are differences. Okay. PySpark, we are going to use it here. Scala will not be touched. Because any one program should you know very well. That's only we will be thinking, because then only you will be clear the interview. Whenever they are asking the question, you don't want to confuse the keywords. Scala keywords and PySpark keywords is completely different Python keywords. So while you go for the interview, you may be stuck some places. So that we will be planning to go with only one string. That should be at least an intermediate level. Then only you'll get a job with confidence. because it was happened in previous batches. During the interview, they will open the Python IDE. They were trying to execute Scala codes, and a lot of confusions. It will indirectly, the panelist who are going to taking you, right? They will be getting irritated. So we'll be planning to go with one program. That's it. But that should be end-to-end. The concept, you must learn it. And Python is easy for your learning aspect to compare Scala. So immediately you want to get the job, Python is a good solution for you. Otherwise, program, you want to learn it properly, and then concept, you want to learn it properly, then only you can look for the jobs. We need a job. So what is the alternative? That's it. Okay, next, block size we have discussed, as well as input split. PyCharm is a part of IntelliJ only. Mitchell is asking one question. IDE, PyCharm or IntelliJ, which one will be more useful for Python? IntelliJ is a, PyCharm is a IntelliJ product only. Jupyter Notebook available, PyCharm available, Spyder is available. VS Code also, they will be integrated with Python nowadays. So based on your use cases and your interest, you can select any one of the IDE and practice it. Even Eclipse also, you can add Python. Mostly used in real time with PyCharm, Jupyter Notebook, and VS Code some places. Okay, so next, yeah, any other question? Adila, any question? Okay, fine. So next, block size we have discussed, input split we have discussed, how it will be going to process in the back. Now we will see how that processing we have seen, right? Data concept, you know. Okay, how did we can go? So heartbeat is nothing but it is an intimations. Okay, this is the yesterday architecture. So here it will be sending some pulse to. I don't have any places. Okay, I can use this one. Okay, look like this one, we can take it out. This is a name node. Rest of them is a data node. Everybody is responding to name node. Here is the data node 1. Here is the data node 2. Here is the data node 3. Okay, so everybody, this all the data node should respond to your name node only. Okay, so whether this is active or not, this kind of pulse will be intimate by a heartbeat. So this will be sent every 3 seconds once from data node to name node for the confirmation. This is called as a heartbeat. Okay, whether I'm active or not, such kind of pulse intimation just sent from data node to name node. Then only name node can confirm data node 1 is active. If suppose data node 1 is down or something has happened, this heartbeat will not be reached to the name node. Immediately name node will, what will do, what are the requests will be reached, right? Any new request or existing request from the client. All the requests will be redirected to other data nodes wherever is available. So right now all the tasks will be tasked on YARN behalf. So based on the YARN only, all the functionality we are going to start and process it. it will be send this information to Yarn. Data node one is down. We need some alternative. Just think like this. So immediately Yarn, what is going to do? It is going to be think about the alternative with respect to name node information, because data node one has this some data. Let's take it up. Some blocks information we just stored. This is the block A. This same data will be replicated to other data nodes as well. This data node will be, the block data will be replicated to data node two. So this is going to be down. Name node have all the metadata information. It will be informed to our Yarn. Right. So immediately Yarn can taking the responsibility with respect to the resource manager. It is going to be informed data node one has failed. It's going to be down. I got the information from name node. Just think about the alternative with other data node something. So immediately resource manager going to be informed to node manager and continue the process. These are all will be taking with four attempts. So each resource manager going to be informed to node manager with multiple tasks, right? So this task attempt, okay, let's take it up. Name node manager one as a data node one. This task only we are going to modify. Task one and task two we have allocated in node manager one. Node manager one is available in data node one. Okay, if suppose data node one goes down, I didn't get this pulse into the name node. Name node, what it will do, it is going to be start the process and monitor where the alternative data is available. Data node two is available. This information again, it will be informed to Yarn. Yarn can take this information and inform to resource manager. Data node one is down. Please do the alternative. And then resource manager is going to be monitored in node manager one, whether it can do the process or not. This process will be validated by four attempts in the backend. Within a four attempt, if it is completed, then till now that accessibility is available with the data node one. If it is, we will not be getting any after the four attempt, it is going to be kill this process, this particular task and all, and create a new one with respect to node manager two and node manager three something. Where the alternative available, there only it's going to be start and continue. Immediately, it will not be do any changes. It will be validated, then only it will be stop this kind of process. Okay, that is the use of Orbit. Any question? This?
So no. How can we check this in real time actually?
Well, heartbeats we cannot validate, but heartbeat interval we can see with some commands we can validate how many seconds it will be sending it. These are Hadoop framework algorithm will be monitored in the backend, okay, based on the logics. So how many seconds the data will be sent from that data node to name node, we can see the intervals, but we cannot monitor this properly. If it is goes down, we have web UA, we have a name node separate web UA is available. That we can see name data node one is commissioned or decommissioned something. That one, once it has happened, then only we can see that. And also name node will be informed to our zookeeper. Separately we have, right? This zookeeper will be informed, and we have separate monitor tools available. There also all the information will be passed. Okay, then only they will be think for this alternative and remove this data node one and add commission with a new data node. So such cases only you have three data node. Unfortunately, data node one is going to be down. By three replica, you will be stored some places, right? Once new data node will be commissioned, all the balance replication 3x will be replicated, then only you can insert a new node. If suppose you are using only three node cluster, three data node, one master, like I said, you are going to use it. That first, whenever that new data node comes, there it will be replicate the data properly, then only the process will be continued whenever the new data is trying to insert. Okay. If data nodes misses one heartbeat, then also name node declare that data node is inactive. it will be monitored. Within a 3 seconds, it should be sent it. This alarm trigger only just monitor. If it is a one, okay, your question is misses one heartbeat. Yeah, right, exactly. It's kind of acknowledgement only. Even a one heartbeat is not reached, a new mode can consider this goes down. And think about the alternative, it will be processed. Immediately data node is available, suddenly it will be sending that heartbeat, it will be stop all the continuous. That's what this four attempt is available. Within the first one, only one heartbeat is supposed to miss due to some network connections. During the time, Ningbot can cancel and inform to the yarn. Yarn will be keep on waiting and inform to the resource manager and node manager, but it will not be kill the process. It will be trying to re-attempt with four times. If it is within the four attempts, it will be revoked, then the normal operation will be continued. It will be sent, this yarn will be resent back to the name node. Please verify once again, I can continue the process of the grid. That is the use of four attempts. Okay. Are you clear, Dheeraj? Any question? Okay, fine, if no questions.
Is there any separate URL to check these things?
Yeah, default URL is available, right? 5700. You can use it for Hadoop 2x. Hadoop 3x8672, you can refer it. I will show you that URL.
Okay, okay.
What happens if the data node goes down in middle of some transactions? Yeah, during the time only, I say, if we cannot connect it properly, immediately what it will do, it is going to be validated with your node managers, whether it is continue or not. Otherwise, it will think about the alternative. Because some places we cannot get the proper information right from the heartbeat also. In the middle is going down, no, it will not be rolled back because the continuous process is going on, right? Single task, this is not with respect to data node one itself. You're going to process n number of data. So all of the name node manager data node is going to be processing for you. This only is going to be down, right? So it will be think of the alternative and continue the process with it. Okay. If suppose you're going to handle 10 GB data, only 2 GB, 1 GB data will be stored in data node one. So we have to continue our business, right? So it will not be rolled back anything. It is continued. Only this latency will be handled with other data nodes, where the space capacity is available as well as data is available. That all will be followed with some protocols in the backend. We don't go in depth in that point. During this talk session, we can discuss how the protocol is going on the back, how it's going to be read the data. Now. Okay. Pulse to name node from data node on every 3 seconds. Next, after the heartbeat, we know about block report. So what is block report? Anyone? Same scenario, we can take it out here. If suppose data is available all the places, it should monitor, right? What kind of data is stored inside? Because metadata should be refreshed all the places. Whenever that changes happen, it should be refreshed. We will connect like that. So inside the metadata, it will be monitored and will be informed. Okay, let me take the data node one. I have ABC file, abc.txt file, which is loaded into data node one itself with four blocks. Example, I'm saying. Okay, you can take one block, two block right now, and the replica will be followed by data node two and data node. Okay. Data node three. These informations we have. So while storing the data, the block report will be monitored whether the data, storage spaces available or such kind of informations, it will be sent to our name node as a report, sometimes. So based on that, only name node can consider where I have to store a new records. abc.txt file is stored in name node, data node one, and replication will be stored some places. If any new data like xyz.txt, some files is coming, I want to store that data also in Hadoop environment. So name node can identify whether it is capable to store in data node one or not. Such kind of capacity validation will be monitored by your block report based only. If the data spaces are available, we can store the data, then name node can consider and inform to the client, you can store your data into data node one. So suppose data node one is completely full, almost 90% threshold will be reached, we cannot store the data properly. Then name node can consider and it will be informed to data node one and two. Like that, it will be informed. So such kind of block report will help you. Just about the block informations. How many blocks will be allocated here? What are the blocks with respect to particular files? And where the data will be stored properly? And how many blocks will be combined for the single files? All the information and what kind of file format it is, all the information will be bring it and given to the name node. That is the process happening in the back. Okay. So interesting questions from this, I can ask you. Edit log. What is the difference between block report and edit log? This is also one of the questions. Well, raise it. Am I audible clearly, guys? Hello.
Yes.
Okay. No noisy, right? It's clear, right?
There is some background noise, but then it's all right.
Okay. Now is it okay?
No, initially only it was good, no issues. Only little, okay. I don't know from where, we are getting that noise, but then okay. You can continue.
Okay. Thank you. So difference between block report and edit log, that is also one of the question they will be asking. So what is the difference between, anyone have idea? What is the use of block report? What is the use of edit log? Yes, Trijit, tell me.
Yeah, one query I had, this just got confused, that FS image and block report, are they same or?
No, that is different.
That is different, okay, sorry.
FS image is different.
Okay.
But this is the common question. Difference between block report and edit log in interviews, mostly they will ask.
Okay. So edit log will have the delta information if I... the block, the which block the information is stored, those kind of information will be there.
Then what is the use of block report? Block report also doing the same only, right?
Right.
Then what is the difference between these two?
Here, what about the metadata of data nodes? Actually, is it saved in name node or metadata is saved in data nodes
itself? All the metadata will be stored in name node only. data node have any responsibility, and it cannot be do that actually. Whatever the data had been mentioned, name node will be stored into the data node based on some block IDs. That's it. Here it will be create one block ID number and it will be stored the data. Even data node also cannot be understand what it is. It is a reserved some spaces by name node. That's it.
So basically the function of data nodes are nothing but functionality provided by name nodes. That's it, right? Yes, apart from that, nothing.
Correct. This is the master, this is the string. So what all the request comes from that master, it is needs to get that and do that analysis. That's it. It will not be doing it by itself. Okay. Just a minute, I can close it. Okay, next, this is the one, right? Edit log. Edit log is nothing but that is also will help for block report only. Difference between edit log and block report. Block report, what is the data is available? Each one of them, how many blocks available and what kind of content will be stored? Such kind of information only will be informed to name node. If suppose you are going to rename the files or you're going to change the folder, because Hadoop also you can move the files from one place to another places, right? Also, you can rename your files also. Once you are stored, you want to change the file name and all, or directory name, anything, you can do that. Or you can delete the data also from your environment. So such kind of changes has happened in within a data node that are all will be going to store in edit log only. Any changes in the data node, that all will be stored in edit log. That is a log. Whether it is a rename the files or moved from one place to another place, all the information. These are all will be combined again and create a new block report and send to name node to refresh the metadata. Then only new data comes, right, immediately to be monitored. Okay. So that is the use of edit log. Block report, just to send the block information, edit log, what are the changes happen in the particular block. Such kind of information will be informed to name node. Okay, are you clear now? Okay, fine.
Okay.
Now I just come to the FS images. FS images full name is called file system images. Okay, FS images only used for your name node and secondary node. So whenever the name node goes down, all the data will be converted as a snapshot and will be sent to secondary name node, and then secondary name node will be read all the data and continue as a primary name node. In middle, this in charge, if any problem is arise, the standby name node will be taking care of. Once secondary name node will take entire in charge, then standby name node again going back as a standby name node with a high availability. It will not be handled huge data, but it can be handled for some time. During the time, secondary name node will take the primary name node in charge and continue. Where name node goes down, first it will be informed to your zookeeper. The zookeeper, what is going to do, it is have some separate federation is available. That is called as a SDFS federation. This federation only can elect a new name node and process it. So not only a secondary name node, even a standby name node also will be a primary name node if it is have a capability. This kind of validation and elections will be taken care by SDFS federations. And then only the process will be continued. Okay? erected a new neighbor, not a new. So how it, the zookeeper is going to be monitored? This will be monitored by the zookeeper file controller. Some concept is available with the quorums. So zookeeper always will be running as a quorum. So based on the quorum only, it will be monitored. If suppose a zookeeper also goes down, what will happen? If zookeeper goes down, you cannot continue the process with your Hadoop cluster. Zookeeper down, just inform to all the places, but it's a very worst case because it keep on, it will, Zookeeper also separate cluster, just monitor what is happening, something like that. So very rare places Zookeeper going to be down, but name will have chances to go down some places. Okay, such kind of monitors happen. FS images is nothing but just a snapshot images. Within a time, it can be read and recontinue the entire metadata information via a secondary name, because it cannot be read all the logs and continue the process immediately. So that name node can give you a snapshot image information. Immediately it can be monitored and will be taking the interest by standby secondary name node. That is the use of FS images. It will be store only the metadata information. So here we are very clear, if data node goes down, immediately heartbeat based name node can understand and following that where the alternative node is, data is available, something. If name node goes down, immediately standby name node as well as secondary name node can take the in charge and will be followed. So all the data we can very secure and followed here in case of any fault tolerances happen, whether it is a network connections or communication, any failures has happened, it will be continue the process. Okay, any questions? Okay, this two only, FS images is taken. Okay, FS images we have discussed. Also, Zookeeper also we just discussed just before. Yeah, I think that's we missed. So if suppose you want to monitor, so you want to know how many standby name node you're using and all, via command you can achieve it. That is HAK admin commands. Some places they will give you access to read it. Some places they will not give you. So if you want to know overall reports, then HDFS, DFS admin report command you can use to read the data as well. Just a reference, I'm just informing you. What else missing here? Name node, data node, secondary name node, standby, yarn, resource, node manager, container, activity master, block size, infosprite, heartbeat, block report, edit log, FS image, zookeeper. Anything that we missed here? Everything we have covered, right?
Dinesh, pardon me. I joined little late. I missed this container and input split. If you could brief me that one again, it would be great, or sometime later also I'm okay.
Okay, no problem. Just a small information, but it's little detail. We'll do one thing. I will give you separate.
Fine, no problem.
Okay, you can refer the video. I will share the video. Otherwise, I will connect it separately.
Fine. I just wanted to go through those three: container, application, water, and master. And
input. No problem.
All right. Thanks.
Okay. Any others? Any question? So most of them we have discussed here. and replications. So replications in Hadoop 2x, they are using by default 3x replications. So if suppose you are going to approach Hadoop 2x via 2x replications, then what is the problem? If suppose you want to store 1 GB of data with 3x replication, then you must spend 3 GB of spaces entirely in your node, Hadoop cluster. So you are getting 200% overhead. This is the only one problem is happening in Hadoop 2x machines. As well, yarn also. Yarn latency, some places happen. That's what in Hadoop 3x version, they are going to introduce another concept is called Azure encoding. So Azure encoding is nothing but it will be following this replication in different manner to avoid this much of overhead memories. Because it will be losing the space, right? Data spaces. One, just you want to process 1 GB, but unfortunately you want to spend 2 GB more. So this kind of 200% overhead we can avoid via Azure encoding concept in 3x version with one.
I have a doubt.
Yeah, please.
Can't we control it manually instead of 3x? Can we control it by 2x or something like that?
If you can do that, but what's if suppose any?
I mean the replication instead of.
If needed, you can control 2x also by creating Hadoop cluster itself. You can inform them. Some only important data you want to manually override, that is also possible. But why they are giving us a 3 replication? They need a secure data.
Secure.
Any places is data goes down. If it is a 2 replication, 2 node also, that is impossible. 95% probability to goes down with the 2 nodes at the same time. So that they will be giving a 3x replication. Because 3x replication, that is 0.01% overhead, they will be confirmed. That's the reason in Hadoop they will be following with 3x replication. Because data node 1 goes down, some places data node 2 also goes down. In this case, you may be lost the data, so, right? Entirely, you may be lost the data. But 3x replication, you can secure your data in some other place. That's the reason. But you can manually override. Or you want to create only 2x, that is also possible. DFS.replication is a kind of config file. You want to change it by creating Hadoop cluster itself. Okay. During inside what are the config files available, we will be discussing sometime. Only this theory part will be discussed right now. Okay, Azure encoding is nothing but it will be following three concepts inside. First one is called parity block. Here it's look like 2x one, it will be followed, but a little interesting one. I will tell you the answer. Next, parity block, right? Okay. And then RS code, RS read Solomon code. Third, XOR algorithm. These three they are using to monitor whether to avoid this 3x replication. This is a kind of 2x only, but it's just using only 50%. Even a 2x is supposed to use 100%, you want to use it, right? 1 GB you want to store 2 GB spaces. Here only 50% is more enough to handle your data. How it is stored inside? Okay, same, I'm going to take it out here. Okay, we can take this one as a data node 1. This is a data node 2, and this is the data node 3. Okay, here it is just trying to split one layer, which is called as a parity layer. Okay, same like here also. Same like here also. Okay, so in this layer, what it is going to do, it is just to monitor. Suppose I'm going to store the data via name node. I can mention my name node here. This is the one of the name node I'm going to use it. So I want to store my data. Let me make some light colors. Same file I'm going to write, xyz.txt. This file I'm trying to write into Hadoop environment and inform to the name node. So name node, what it is going to do, it is going to be trying to write the data into data node one first. Okay, so this is, we can take for right now, just 126 MB we can take it, 28 MB. This data will be stored here. Okay, there's a block. We can mention the block E. This data 128 MB completely stored here. Example I'm saying, TXT file will be stored here. Just imagine. Now, what it will do, it is going to be make some compressed informations. So this is called a CKC. Compressed data is going to be stored where the actual replica is trying to update it. This is the one parity. Same like here, another parity. But this is a 128 MB. If it is compressed, then it will come minimum 10 MB or 20 MB maximum. Such kind of compressed file will be stored in this kind of parity places. So 20 MB, how much it comes? Almost 40 MB, right? This is a compressed file. Like that, it will be stored. If suppose my node is going to be down, data node one is going to be down, and it's continuing the process, and it'll be informed. This entire data node goes down. I don't want to make that. Data node one is completely down. Immediately, data node two, what is going to do? It is uncompress the particular data and will be stored into actual places. So same XYZ file will be uncompressed and stored here as a new file. Same data, same block. If suppose a data node 1, 2 also fully locked, then what it will do, data node 3 is going to be uncompressed and will be created here. So you have a data alternative. This is a lightweight compressions. Like it will not make any complex, only data algorithm is trying to pick it up and immediately uncompress. Such things only it will be used here. You understand my point, what I'm saying here? This is a little confusing some places. Are you clear, everyone? Or any questions in this point?
Dinesh, what is the meaning of that parity?
Yeah, this is a pair, right? This node has the parity here, two parity. Instead of replication, what is happening? Replication, data actually replicate all the places, actual data.
Yes,
it is just compressed and it will be identified the parity. This data will be stored in this too. So name node, how it will be monitored, this information here. xyz.txt file will be stored, in a main file will be stored in data node one, and parity will be stored in data node 2 and data node 3.
You're right. My question is, what is the meaning of the parity means actually?
Par block. Par is a parity, that's it.
Okay.
Par means two, so it should be combined two.
In that one data node, it has a pair.
Each block have a pair.
Okay, great.
Okay.
The data compression, the replica of the data getting into the parity, basically it is an automated one.
Yeah, by default, if it is not available, automatically this will be uncompressed and stored in this places. It will not be wait for any time. And name node can confirm, data node 1 goes down. Immediately yarn will be start the process layer and everything will be monitored. And storage layer, name node will be informed to data node 2, just uncompress the file. With the commands is reached, immediately data node 2 or 3, any one only will be uncompressed. Both will not be uncompressed. Anyone just confirm and give the acknowledgement, I uncompress the file and which is stored in my node properly like that. Okay. Clear.
Clear, Dinesh. Clear.
Others? This is an interesting concept, but it may be confusing if you are supposed to know. This is Hadoop 3x only they have introduced to avoid the data sizes and all.
Okay. And let's take a particular data node gone down. Mm. And immediately the next replica, which is sitting on another data node on the parity and which is in the compressed format.
Mm.
When that start running, let's take for example, in the data node 1, the process had completed, let's take 50%, right?
Mm, okay.
And it completely gone down. And in data node 2, it is in a compressed format.
Okay.
And obviously the compressed format will come to the data node 2 completely to run the process.
Mm.
That will understand it will start from the 50th percentage or 50%.
No. It will start from the 0 only. If it is the same data node, trying to reattempt and continue the process. Otherwise, this only one block have one task only, right? Because correct. Number of inputs split based only, that mapper will be generated. Mapper based only, your core will be created. Core and RAM, which means container and application masters, right?
Yeah.
So if it is a particular mapper is not completed properly, the same will be created here and will be continued.
I mean, it'll again,
from the zero.
Okay.
0% itself, it just started. Because already that all the container application master is running here only. Data node 1. If entirely data node 1 goes down, it will not be move any cache data from here to there.
Okay.
So what will happen? Data node 2 is going to be start and continue the process from the beginning for the particular task. If let's take it out, 10 tasks you have for the particular request. Mm-hmm. 8 is completed, 2 goes down from the data node 1. Immediately, what it will do, where the alternative is available, there the particular task will be create and execute from the beginning. Until that, all other the tasks completed, right, will be wait, but it will be stored in the cache. Like that, it will be happen the back. Okay?
Right. Okay.
That's the reason intermediate value, combiner concept it comes. Combiner, reducer, mini reducer is called a combiner. But it's an old one, we don't want to confuse one. What else I missed? Okay, parity block we discussed. And then Reed-Solomon algorithm, right? Algorithm. So this is will help to identify whether the file will be properly compressed or not. Interesting thing is this one only. Those look like fine. Okay. Whenever the data, you just consider the message is kind of your data. Whether it is properly compressed, then only it will be decoded. Okay. If it is not properly compressed, then it will be creating some noisy because your data maybe have chance to corrupt while supposed to compress the file, right? You may be forcingly you're trying to compress your data, you cannot be reworked back. So such kind of any noise data will be combined and your file is going to be corrupt. This RS encoder is going to be validate this data whether properly compressed or not. If it is not properly compressed, just release the data and again it's trying to compress the data from the beginning. Because you don't have any proper replication data here. Only one data, actual data, others is compressed. If suppose this is corrupted, you cannot read the data from there again. So that RS code going to be validate before uncompress it. As well, compress it, both places. Okay, this is a noisy data. If it is any noisy will be combined, you cannot, you may be compressed, but you cannot read the data properly. Okay, this is the same concept you are using in your CD, DVD, CD, VCD, whatever you will be practiced. That if any cracks happen, you cannot read the data properly there, the particular video clips under. There also this Reed Solomon code algorithm only, they will use it. Same concept here, they are using for data validations. Whether the data properly compressed and stored into other data nodes or not something. Okay. Any questions? Sorry to ask, but I'm in learning phase. My question is, data goes down, the data to become a replica of data node one using parity compressed file. So what will be happen if data node two has already 50% occupied with its own data? When the data one data needs more spaces, then data, it's not like that. That's what I said. If data space is not available, it will be identified and will be uncompressed, or it will be compressed data other where the parity is available. If it is 50%, 80% is over, there is no place to store it here. Then where the alternative? Here it will be doing that compressed operations. If suppose the processing is going on, data node one is completely goes down. You cannot do any process with data node one. As well as 90%, it's already 95%, it's data node two also will be filled. That data node three will be replicate the data properly. So while compressed data, uncompressed data, everything will be validated by your name node. So in the back end, there is a lot of algorithm in name node they are using for the validation purpose. Okay, there it will be taking this kind of operations. Are you clear now? Somebody asked me in chat so that. Okay, thank you. Okay, so here also we just discussed about RS code, right? Reed Solomon code algorithm. So this is will be validate whether the data will be compressed. While compressing, it will be creating some noisy or not. If no noisy, all the data properly will be encoded, then only the compression will happen here. If any noisy will be raised, yeah, if the data is not properly trying to compress here, then it will be released from here and trying to compress from the beginning again. Until that, the name data node will not be giving the confirmation to name node whether the data properly compressed or not. Something. This kind of process validation will be taken care of by each data node itself. Who is getting the data from where? Okay. This is a very important thing. RS code and mostly engineering syllabus, Reed Solomon code algorithms available. Okay, if you want to know more details, then you can refer from there also. And third one, any question in this or shall I go next? Okay, fine. Third XOR algorithm, just to monitor whether the data will be equally distributed and compressed from other places or not. Just such kind of validation will be taken care by XOR. XOR gateway is nothing but just a gate. This is XR, right? Yeah. Very small. Yeah, this could be a fine. So XR gateway, there is no places without replica you will not be using. So this is now will not happen at any causes, right? This is never will happen. And you will not be replicate same data in other places. So this two will not be available. Only data is not replicated, then it's trying to replicate with 1x replication, any one of the data. Because before the parity, XR gateway only going to validate data node 1 and 2. You can consider A as a data node 1, B as a data node 2. Just trying to monitor to validate data node 1 have the data, data node 1 have the data, but which is not paired with data node 2 something. Then it will be informed, okay, just to make some parity. Like that, data node have data and it's just not compressed and stored with data node 1, then make some parity with. This kind of information already get from your name node. Who's going to replicate the data with respect to the particular block? That's it. Okay. These are three concepts mostly using for RSA encoding. Any questions on this? Almost we have discussed all the theory topics. Okay. If no questions, we can see with some sample projects. So something like, you can see the data here. Now I just go here and read the data. DFS-LS. File has to be generated. I'm going to read all the data from here. So you can see all is only one time, it just reflect. Hello two times, two 18 times, big data period 21, two times, welcome after 20 times. This is just a basic information. How you are going to make via automations and you are going to execute your scripting via MapReduce. This is the best reference for everyone. Any questions on this? Everyone? Any questions?
No, it's clear, Tanish.
Okay, fine. And then what kind of projects you're going to learn it? There's also a few of them is asking me in separate how the capstone projects look like. So almost you're going to learn 14 projects. Common Hadoop MapReduce, Hive Batch, PySpark Batch, as well as streaming, and Kafka, Spark, Hive, using sensor, you're going to do some analysis, such kind of projects, streaming projects you're going to see, and then Twitter related streaming projects, and Kafka, Cassandra, Docker integrations. So via streaming itself, you can see this one. And Docker Spark integrations with RDBMS. All are created as a container and practice it. As well, Airflow, Hive, and Spark integrations. Via scheduler, how Hive and Spark automatically will be connected together and run it in the backend scheduler. And then cloud, AWS, EMR, batch processing, and AWS, Kinesis, DynamoDB, serverless integration. I don't like to share the architecture now. So just giving you an overview. and then Azure Data Lake, Gentoo and Kafka integration platforms, as well as SD Insight. It's like AMR and Azure. So how real-time you're going to practice with SD Insight and Data Lake, Gentoo. Mostly Data Lake only they are using. How it is interactive. And finally, Azure, Snowflake, Azure Data Lake, Kafka, AWS, Kinesis, and Spark. Everything will be combined and will create a project via Snowpipe integrations, whether it is AWS or Azure. Any one place, we are going to use it and monitor it. These are the projects you are going to use. These are the combinations. Okay. Somebody's asked me in private, I'm just giving you in open now. Any questions on this point also, you can ask me, we can discuss.
So this Kinesis and Kafka both are messaging frameworks, right?
Exactly. Okay. Kafka is an open source Hadoop platform they are using. If suppose you want to learn via AWS, so there you must know, right, what is Kinesis, how it is working.
Okay.
So the similarity and the architecture, everything will be discussed and we can go forward in this point. How you are going to interact via Python and PySpark something. Okay. Because you are going to practice in AWS, then you must know about Kinesis also.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's what.
This Kinesis is actually a paid account, right? So if you join for the course, we will not have an account, right?
I'm also paid and I can show you.
Okay.
Paying to me so that I just take the responsibility and just showing you. That's it.
Okay.
How you are going to create the Kinesis service, how you are going to use it properly, how you can turn it, everything we are going to see.
Okay.
That's what I just said. This is a relevance to data engineering. It's a paid service only we are going to use in some place.
Mm-hmm.
Mostly S3, maybe a few as a free services we are going to use it. DynamoDB also some places. It depends on that. What's the capacity based, it will be modified. Rest of the EMR, SD Insight, everything is a paid service only. We don't have any options. But it's a learning. You know that, then you can get the job.
Right?
Yeah. That's a priority.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any other questions? All about Python and PySpark related only. We are going to use it. Any questions? So already I informed you about the payment. You can pay by threefold. First, you can pay 5,000 rupees. And a refund, if suppose you want to come out from our batch, 100%, you're supposed to ask within a month. After that, next month you want to pay 5,000. After third month, you want to pay 10,000 rupees. If it is a full stack, if supposed to select as a full stack dollar. Others will be modified something. It's based on your selections. We can monitor and we will update you. Clear? Any questions? Next week onwards, it should be a paid session. So just to confirm. Okay. All this recording, everything, we will be create a separate private drive and we will share that link to you.
Hello, Dinesh.
Yeah, please.
This is Praveen.
Yeah, tell me.
Yeah. So, this.
Oh, sorry, voice breaking.
So, can you hear me now?
Yeah, please.
So this is only weekend batch, right?
Right now it's a weekend batch only.
So Saturday, Sunday.
Yeah, the same time. Exactly. Same time, 6 to 8, it will be connected.
Okay. 2 hours. Okay. So how many weeks this batch continues?
Yeah, almost 3 to 4 months it will go.
3 to 4 months.
All the content, whatever you mentioned, right, that we must be covered. That's very important. This project included. So for each, if suppose Hadoop is covered properly, we are going to discuss the Python and what are the MapReduce code we have written, right? That is, we are going to discuss. Like that Hive is covered, we are going to see our projects. Something like okay. Each one of the project, everything is covered, one time we are going to monitor it.
So this project scripts also you will provide, right? Once we do project.
Exactly. Come. You are going to practice it and we are going to give you assignments. If suppose okay. You are clearing the assignments, who is clear that all the assignments? Almost we will give you 20 assignments. Who has to done that 20 assignments as a first, they will get 5,000 rupees as a rewards.
Okay, and this project code also, right? I will give
yeah.
Entire end-to-end project.
Yes, exactly. This project code I will share you, but learning yeah. Purpose, overall is interested, we need to give some rewards, right? So
right, 5,000
rupees is the rewards. Second person's, because without interest, we cannot go forward. Second person,
yep.
Who is that? They will get 4. Third person, 3. First 3 members only in a batch.
Oh, great.
If suppose you are clear all the assignments properly, you have any doubt, you can ask us. We can help you. If you are clear, then definitely you can get the job. I'm sure. Because with your involvement, if supposed to work, then definitely you'll get it. I'm sure.
So this is like fast track only, right? Fast track
basis. No, it's slow track.
Slow track.
Yeah, that's what the content basis I'm saying. There's an interview basis and content basis only.
Okay.
So we will not be going hurry-burry.
Sure, sure.
Any place you have a doubt, you can unmute and ask us. And once you clear your doubts, then only we can go forward.
Okay, but sir.
Try to join us correct time. That's very important, right? If you are delayed late, if you join a little late, then that will be, you want to learn it from the video only. Or else we will discuss the end.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Any other questions?
Hi.
Yeah, please.
How many months course is this?
3 to 4 months, ma'am. Okay. For an entire full stack, I'm saying.
3 to 4.
Yeah. That is the so 4 options
available. Will be getting any certification after completion?
No, ma'am. We will not be. This is completely relevant to interview basis. I'm sure you'll clear the interview with 80%, I'm sure. If you're supposed to monitor and properly work out all the hands-ons. Because we hear all the projects, we are going to cover it, right? That's the relevance to project-related. Real-time project-related only, this will be covered. So if you have practiced well, definitely you'll get a job. The problem in certification, you want to learn a particular tool in depth. So how many tools you can do that like that? If you are working as any other domain, you want to convert into the big data platform, then you must learn it very well, right? So that's such kind of full stack data engineering only we're just giving you. Yeah, sorry. Did you say anything? This is not relevance to certification. Okay, this is relevance to your job interviews.
And sorry, I lost connection. Now I got back.
There's not relevance to certification. Again, I'm saying
okay, that's it. Okay,
it's
okay.
An interview basis. All the content should you can go through our syllabus. It's matched with the interview basis. Or each content, whatever you mentioned, that is also relevance to interview basis one.
Okay.
So that this real-time projects will definitely help you while you're going to work it out and you go for the interview. But we need your involvement. That's only we just expected. Also, minimum 8 GB RAM in your laptop or system. Otherwise, you cannot work it properly. More than 8 GB is fair enough to us. And assignments, we will be keep on monitor. For completing the assignments as much as they, we will reward them also at the end of the batch. Okay. Any other question? We need your involvement, to be frank, I'm saying. We will try out.
This is Praveen again. Actually, I pinged you earlier also regarding any project support. We will discuss after the call if you're free.
Today, yeah. I have a little work. Tomorrow, I will ping you. Because after
okay,
this,
tomorrow.
I have another call also.
Oh, okay, sure, sir. No issues. Yeah.
Any other question? Okay, if no questions, we can close it today. Okay, guys, thank you all. Thanks for joining here. Bye.